axis is inclined to VP at 30 degrees. Now in the second position, when the base edge is resting on HP, so the axis is inclined at 45 degrees to HP, so you are getting the apparent length. But here the inclination is given is the true inclination, so on the true inclination line you have to get only the true length of the axis. But here, since the second position top view, what we have is the apparent length, so we cannot transfer on that in the 30 degree line, so we need to find out the apparent inclination. To find out the apparent inclination, since you have the true inclination line of 30 degree, you take the true length of the axis, which is 60 mm. So from consider any point on that 30 degree line and cut an arc on that 30 degree line to get the point. Then you draw the locus line, and with the, since it is, the axis is inclined at 45 degrees, take the top view of the axis which has got the apparent length of O to O1. From the same point O, you cut an arc on the locus point to get the point O1. Once you get the point O1, then join these two, which becomes a center line, which is OO1. Now, since this AD is crossing that OO1 line, so you measure the length from O to this point. So then from O, you cut an arc on OO1 line to get this point. So from this point, since AD is perpendicular to this OO1, from this point, you measure by using the protractor, you measure 90 degree with respect to OO1 line and then draw a line. So draw an incline, draw a perpendicular line to that OO1. Then from here, you measure the length of from this point to A and also from this point to D. So both will going to have the same length. From this point, you cut an arc on this side by using the compass. Similarly, from this point to the other side, so that you are going to get the point A and also the point D. Then through this point A and D, draw perpendicular by using the protractor. You measure an angle of 90 degree with respect to AD and also from the point D. So draw these perpendicular lines, and by using the compass, you measure the length from A to B and you cut an arc on this, and also from D, you cut an arc on this to get the point B and C respectively. So once you get these four points and also O and O1, then complete the view exactly similar to the one what we have written in the second position top view. The same thing has to be written here also without changing any visible and invisible edges. Once you rewrite the sketch of the third position top view, now we have to write the corresponding front view in the third position. So to do that, draw a vertical projector from O and draw a horizontal projector from O dash to get this point O dash here. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from A and also from D to the XY line, because A dash D dash is on the XY line, and draw a horizontal projector from A dash D dash to get this point A dash and D dash. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from O1 and the horizontal projector from O1 dash to get this point O1 dash. Similarly, you draw a vertical projector from C and also from B to the front view, and draw a horizontal projector from B dash C dash to get this point B dash and C dash. Once you get all these four points, then join these points by using continuous thin lines. So join between A dash to B dash, B dash to C dash, C dash to D dash, and D dash to A dash. Then you join between O dash to A dash, O dash to B dash, O dash to C dash, and O dash to D dash, and join O dash O1 dash with a center line with a big dash small dash. Once you do that, now we are going to apply the condition of visibility. So what is the condition of the visibility? All the exterior edges, so we can see here, all the exterior edges of the boundaries of the solids are visible. So O dash, A dash, A dash, D dash, D dash, C dash, C dash, O dash is on the boundary. So you dark all these lines with a continuous dark lines. And then when you look from the front view, since A, B, C, D is near to the observer, so it becomes visible. So when you look from the front view, A, B, B, C, C, D, D, A are near to the observer, it is visible. So A dash, D dash is already visible, and D dash, C dash is already visible. So now we will going to join between C dash B dash and B dash A dash, which is on the continuous line.
So which will be able to see these base. So the base becomes visible. So it will be continuous lines. Since B dash is not on the boundary, from the B dash we are having two emanating edges. One it is three emanating edges. One is B dash C dash, and from B dash A dash, and also O dash B dash. Since B dash C dash is a visible edge, and also B dash A dash is a visible edge, so obviously the third edge, which is O dash B dash, is also becomes visible. So you dark this line. So the only left out is O dash D dash. Since O dash D dash is crossing that visible edge A dash B dash, so we have the one more condition that two visible edges can never cross each other. So by applying that rule, here O dash D dash will going to become invisible. And since A dash B dash C dash D dash and A dash, it becomes a complete rectangular surface which is totally visible. So obviously O1 dash is on that surface, so O1 will going to become visible. So that is evident from here also. When you look from the front view, O1 is near to the observer, and also since the base is visible, so naturally O1 will become visible. So this is the final position of the three dimensional sketch. When you heard, this is the actual position of the solid in the final condition. So now, whether the problem is right or wrong, which we will going to analyze it here. So here is a square pyramid of base 35 mm side and 60 mm axis length rests on one of its edges of the base, such that the axis is inclined at 45 degrees to HP and the same axis is inclined to VP at 30 degrees. So since it satisfies all the conditions, and hence our problem is right. Thank you.